I like to put a star by it or circle it, draw a little box around it, something that makes it stand out on my scratch paper. We're going to talk about smart numbers as they apply to the technique we're learning today. What kind of numbers are the best choices to help us hack these algebra problems? We're going to see how we can kind of avoid using actual algebra when solving certain algebra problems. And we're going to try to navigate any possible traps or issues with this technique and just overcome them and be great. We're going to do this mostly through practice problems. But before we start on some practice math problems, let's talk about the technique itself. It's called plugging in numbers. And this technique can also be called picking numbers. Plugging in really captures the spirit of what we're going to do. Wherever we have letters in algebra, we're going to plug a number in instead, and that's going to help us out. Here's what you need to know. It's a technique that involves choosing your own numbers to plug in. That's where the smart numbers will come in. And solving algebra problems using arithmetic or basic math. Arithmetic is everything we did before algebra, working with numbers, adding, subtracting, multiplying, dividing, and so on. Your clue that this strategy of plugging numbers is an option, your clue is when you see variables in the answer choices. AC here stands for answer choices. So if you're working on a problem on the GRE, maybe it's multiple choice or multiple select, maybe even quantitative comparison, and there are variables in the answer choices or variables in the columns on a QC question, look for opportunities to use this technique. It might be able to help you through a lot of questions in less stressful and more accurate ways. Here are the basic steps that we're going to need to follow. Number one, pick a number that's easy to work with and follows the rules in the problem. What does that mean? If the problem says we're talking about a negative integer or a multiple of 3, you have to follow those rules. Also, if it talks about something like the number of people or the price to buy an object, you have to use a little reasoning. Well, a number of people has to be a whole number. We're not going to say fractions. And if we're talking about the price of an object, we need a positive number. So honor the problem as it's described, but really you want to pick numbers that are going to be easy for you to work with. And I want for every variable you pick a number for, write down on your scratch paper what number you picked. Here are some good, smart, easy numbers to use. Some of our very favorite easy numbers to use in anything are 0 and 1. They can be great options. Sometimes you might need a positive even number, so we can add 2 to the list. Some questions might require a negative. And some questions might require a fraction. So our favorite fraction, the one we're most familiar with, is 1/2. This list can be some inspiration to help you pick the easiest possible numbers to work with. But again, always honor the rules in the problem. If we need a multiple of 5 or something like that, follow what the problem says. And here's another great tip. If you're working with percents, remember percent means divided by 100. That's what the word percent means. So if you're going to have to divide something by 100, let it be a multiple of 100. So a number like 100, 200, 300 is a great number to plug in on percent problems. Step 2, after we've chosen those numbers, is we're going to plug those numbers in for the variables in the original problem and solve the problem, find the numerical value that is the answer. We also want to write this down and make sure that it's very easy to find on your paper. I like to put a star by it or circle it, draw a little box around it, something that makes it stand out on my scratch paper. Step 3, we're going to take those same values that we picked for the variables, plug them into the answer choices, again, AC for answer choices, each of the answer choices, and POE. POE stands for the process of elimination. What does that mean? That means we're going to plug the numbers in. If they match the solution number we found, great. If not, we're going to eliminate them. We're going to cross them out. On your scratch paper, I like to actually write down the letters A, B, C, D, and E, since we're talking about a computer-based test. And I will cross out the letters that don't match until there's only one left. Because you picked your own numbers, it's possible once in a while that you won't have only one answer choice left at this point. So it's not going to happen super often, but let's discuss if that does happen. If you're not down to only one answer choice, no problem. Still eliminate the ones that didn't match. Those are eliminated forever. Pick a different value for the variables and repeat the process. It'll be faster the second time because you already know what the calculations are like. And only test the answer choices you haven't eliminated yet. So if that happens, there's your surefire way to get a right answer.